Hey everybody, welcome back to One Seed, One World. So today I'm out in the greenhouse and I'm going to be up-potting some of the plants that I had started in the basement over, well, I guess it was about 6 weeks ago? No, not even, probably about a month ago. I've got four different types of tomatoes, a couple different types of eggplant, and a couple different types of peppers here. This isn't everything that I need to up pot, but I figured I'd get started today. I was actually hoping that I could not even do this. I was hoping that I could just kind of transplant directly outside, but I still probably have a good 2 weeks, maybe even a little bit more before I can transfer this stuff outside, because I want my temperatures at night to be 50 degrees or above to give them the best chance and to reduce any chances of blossom end rot for the tomatoes, because temperatures under 50 degrees, if you've seen any of my previous videos on the subject, can really affect blossom end rot, or cause blossom end rot, I guess I should say, because temperatures under 50 make the plants have a hard time getting the nutrients that they need up out of the soil and to transfer it throughout the plant. And then you can end up with blossom end rot. Watering and other things can affect it too, but one thing that happens a lot is colder temperatures. So, because these plants have been doing so well down in the basement and getting pretty big, I'm afraid they're gonna get maybe root bound, or you know, some of them are getting kind of loopy, floppy, whatever you want to call them. They're kind of flopping over a little bit. And so I want to give them more room, put them in a little bit bigger pot. And then probably starting next week, when it's supposed to be back up in the 70s, then I will start hardening off and then transfer them outside. We've had some weird weather here this spring. Like Friday, it was 88 degrees Fahrenheit. And today, which is Sunday, 58 degrees Fahrenheit. So we've had a 30 degree temperature drop just over the weekend, after we had a rainstorm come through and kind of cooled everything off. And tonight and tomorrow night is supposed to only be in the high 30s. So I will not leave these out here, especially because they haven't been hardened off yet either. But the greenhouse does not stay very warm at night. It does stay maybe 2 or 3 degrees warmer than it would outside. But because, you know, I built this with these old recycled windows, there's a hole in one of them, some of them have cracks, there's gaps, you know, so it doesn't hold in the heat very well, although it does get very hot in here in the summertime. So, when you're transplanting or up-potting, you know, you might see some reduction in your growth for a little bit. Your plants will slow down because it's kind of a traumatic experience for them, and especially if, because you're, you know, you're not going to be able to perfectly keep all of your roots from breaking and everything. You're going to have to kind of prime apart, especially, I'm thinking, I mean, look at the roots hanging out of here. I'm thinking they'll probably be pretty intertwined in there. And so they'll, you know, slow their growth for a while, and they're going to have to recover from that. So don't be alarmed, but if your plants look a little rough for a few days after up-potting, because it can happen, but they'll recover over time as long as you're not horribly rough with them, like ripping everything apart too badly. So that's what we're going to try to do today, and also get some of the weaker, smaller plants out of here. Like in this particular pot, I've got two strong ones, and this one's not doing bad, but it's if I can get it pried out, I'm kind of intertwined. You know, it's kind of right in there together. And so this one, I'll probably just break off and get rid of that one and keep the strong one. So this is some of my Dr. Weechi yellow. For the varieties I'm doing this year, I'm doing Dr. Weechi yellow, which is a big yellow, awesome slicer tomato. They can get pretty big. I've had a couple that were about 2 pounds. And they're very sweet, tasty, juicy. And I know a lot of people don't always go for the yellow tomatoes, but if you're gonna go for a variety, I've done them probably 3 years in a row now, and they do really excellent. They also seem to be more disease resistant these are always the ones that live the longest throughout the whole summer and produce into the fall and tend to not get some of the blight and fungus and other things that maybe like a Cherokee purple or, you know, some of these other varieties can get. For whatever reason, the Dr. Weechi yellow seems to fight that off better. Then I am doing Cherokee purple because I love those. They are some of the best slicers I've ever had. They do tend to sometimes get, you know, the blight or some, you know, they're more susceptible to that as some of the heirlooms are, or like cat facing where you get like the weird bumpy, ugly tomato. They kind of tend, some of them will do that sometimes. But overall, they're still a fantastic tomato. I'm also doing just your general beefsteak tomato this year. I haven't done those in probably 3 years or so. And we wanted to just kind of get some standard beefsteak tomatoes going on. And then I changed up my cherry tomatoes this year for a different one. The last 2 years I've done the Chadwick cherry. Before that I did the blueberry, which I think is Wild Boar Farms. And this one is... it's something strawberry. I just have it marked as B straw, and I don't remember the whole name of it, but it's something strawberry, and it's supposed to be another good cherry tomato. So we'll see how they do for me this year. And these are already getting out of hand. So I'm gonna get to up-potting. And if you have any other questions about up-potting with things, feel free to put comments below and let me know, or you know, give this video a like if you found any of this information helpful. And if you haven't already, subscribe to the channel. So, I'm going to start off with these Dr. Weechis, and like I mentioned, this one, to reduce the amount of damage I'm doing to the roots instead of trying to, you know, pull them apart. This one I'm just pinching off low, and we will get rid of that one there. And then these two, I'm going to separate. Can kind of see too, like some of my soil looks a little rough, had some algae going on. I did put some cinnamon on, I think early on when they were first sprouting, to reduce that, but I didn't keep up with it. And I haven't really treated my plants in the basement too well. I've got so many other projects going on that I have not kept up with all the maintenance of the plants that I should have been doing. So they're, the fact that they've done so well is definitely a testament to them and not to my work. So just a couple little tips here when you're doing your up-potting. After I've removed any of the ones that I don't want out of here, I will see these little bottom leaves. I always pinch those off. Let me see that. And the plant will heal really quick from that. That just gives you a little bit more room to work. And keeping bottom leaves off the soil is better for preventing any fungus from coming up off the soil. The root hanging off of that. So, then I'll just, see if I can do this on, you can see on the camera. Just kind of squeeze a little bit around the sides, loosen up the soil. And start working it out. Oh, I lost part of that root. Kept part of it, but part broke off. And so you can maybe see all the roots in there. But it's pretty loose. It's not root bound. They're just kind of working their way around in. And so now I'm going to separate these two plants and just kind of take it in the middle, because when I planted them, I kind of planted them on either side of the pot so they would kind of be separated and make it easier in the future when I had to do something like this. And just kind of gently work on pulling it apart. And now you've got your two tomatoes, or two tomato plants, with the bulk of their root bases. Some definitely broke, you know, in the process, but now they can be replanted. And when I'm starting them in a bigger pot, I start off with some soil, some extra soil in the bottom, just to get them going. me a little bit more. So that maybe it's, you know, about a quarter full in there. And then just set that on top, your plant. And then I'll pack more soil all the way up to the top. And I kind of press it in there, not like, I mean, not hard packed down, but to keep it kind of firm, give the plant a little bit more support. That's pretty good. Add my label. Good to go. Okay, so I got all my tomato plants transplanted. I did not get to the peppers and eggplant today. They're going to have to wait because it started to get later in the day. Temperature started to drop. It's getting kind of windy outside. And I still have to carry all this stuff back up to the house and into the basement. But they transplanted pretty well. They're starting to look a little wilty, which is normal when you first transplant or up pot. I'm going to give them all some bottom watering. Let that soak in before I carry them up. And then we will be good to go. I had, I think, three plants that I kind of broke when I was doing the transplanting. But I kind of tucked them down in there, added more soil around them, and we're gonna see if those three survive. First one was just a semi-break. The other two were badly broken, so I don't know how they're gonna come out, but we'll see. For peppers and eggplant, I've got banana peppers, poblano peppers, green bell peppers, and then I also planted some Thai red chili, but only one of those came up. They were old seeds. I wasn't really expecting them to do a lot, but I did have one pop, and really that's all you need. If I can get that one to continue to grow and put off some peppers, then I can save the seeds for that and have a whole new batch going forward. So we'll see if I can save that one. And then I also did paprika peppers, paprika pepper, because I want to make my own paprika this year. Maybe even try some smoked paprika. So we'll see how that all goes. So, gonna get these waters and then get them all back inside until the cold weather's over. And so that is it for up potting in the greenhouse today. So again, if you got questions, put comments below. And I appreciate that you're stopping by and hanging out with me again today. And I hope whatever's going on in your neck of the woods is working out fantastic for you and that you are having a great day. We'll see you again soon. Namaste.